morning students, how are you all? I hope you all are good. Welcome back to mathematics class. All of you on your videos. Rayan, on your video. And take out the mathematics textbook and running notes and pencil. All of you sit right, children. Okay, in previous class we discussed about rounding numbers and simplification of expressions. Yes, am I right, children? Okay, in today's class we will discuss about unitary method. Okay, unitary method, fifth unit, unitary method. Take out the textbook, page number 63. What is unitary method? What is unitary method? Okay. Once we want to go to shop. Yes? Are you going shop or not? By buying things. Yes? We are going to shop for buying things. For example, we want to buy 3 pens. Okay? 3 pens. We want to buy 3 pens. But first, what we ask to shopkeeper? What we ask to shopkeeper? First, we ask him to shopkeeper. First, one of the cost, one of the pen cost. Yes, am I right, children? First, one pen cost how much, uncle? Yes, we ask him to that one only, first of all. After, we calculating in our mind what, okay, one pen cost is 10 rupees. For example, shopkeeper said one pen cost is 10 rupees. Then we are calculating. What we are calculating? Just one pen cost is 10 rupees. So 3 pens cost is 30 rupees. Then we will give 30 rupees to shopkeeper, right? We will buy the 3 pens. Yes, children? Am I right or not? Akshaya? Yes. Okay. In these problems related to unitary method, the cost of many things in given problem. Okay, the cost of many things in given problem. In given problem, many things cost given. Then what we have to find out first? One of the cost. Yes. Next, to find cost more or less. Many things cost given in problem. We have to find out first one of the cost. Afterwards, we have to find out many things cost and less things according to given problem. For doing this problem, for doing this first, we first go from many to one, then one to many things, from one thing to many things, from many things to one thing. Okay, I will explain one problem, then you will clarify them. Okay, for example, the cost of dozen apples. The cost of dozen apples is rupees 48. Find out the five apples cost. Okay, for example problem, I am explaining about one example. attend this problem. The cost of dozen apples is rupees 48. Dozen apples cost is 48 rupees. In this given problem, dozen apples cost is 48 rupees. We have to find out the 5 apples cost. Cost of 5 apples. First, what we do, children? First, dozen. Dozen means how many things? Dozen means how many articles? Dozen means how many, children? Dozen. Yes, very good, Rayan. 12 articles, 12 things. Okay. Dozen equal, one dozen equal 12 articles. 12 articles. Okay. Now 12 apples cost is 48 rupees. Find out the 5 apples cost. Cost of 5 apples. What we do first? We have to find out one apple cost. Okay. We have to find out first one apple cost. Cost of one apple. How can we find out cost of one apple? 48 divided by 12. Okay, 48 divided by 12. Cost of the apples. Rupees 48. First, we have to find out here cost of one apple. Cost of one apple. How can we find out, Sina? 48 divided by 12. 48 divided by 12. We can find out one apple cost. 48 divided by 12. How much? Yes, very good. Sathvik, 4. One apple cost is 4 rupees. Okay? One apple cost is 4 rupees. Then we can find out 5 apples cost. Cost of 5 apples. Say, children, cost of 5 apples. Already we learned in previous classes multiplication and division. Yes, very good. 5 fours are 20. Yes, very nice. Good, children. 5 is 10. Okay. See, children, here we are given one problem, but we have to do two solutions here. First, we are given what? First of all, cost of dozen apples. Cost of dozen apples is rupees 48 rupees given. We have to find out 5 apples cost. But when we find out the 5 apples cost, first we have to find out first one apple cost. Okay? We have to find out first one apple cost. What is the cost of one apple? Then we have to find out 5 apples cost. How can we find out first one apple cost? First, what is dozen? What is the meaning of dozen? Dozen means how many articles? We know that one. What dozen means? 12 articles. Okay, 12 apples cost is 48 rupees. Then we have to find out one apple cost. What is the cost of one apple? Yes, 48 divided by 12. 4. Okay, one apple cost is 4 rupees. Then we have to find out cost of 5 apples. 5 fours are 20. 20 rupees is 5 apples cost. Okay, did you understand, children? What is unitary method? How can we solve in unitary method problems? Cost of one apple, rupees 4. Next, cost of 5 apples, rupees 10. Okay, very good, Meghana. Understand? Very good, children. Write down. Now Now I will explain from exercise 5.1. Okay. First problem. Page number 64, children. Take out the textbook. In your textbook, page number 64. Exercise 5.1. First bit. First one. Veena bought me. For rupees 480. How much will it cost? If she bought five such bags, first read the question, children. First read the problem. First you understand that problem. First of all, Veena, listen, Amma. Nirma, stop writing there. Look at the board. First, Veena bought a pair of handbags for rupees 480. Pair means, what is the meaning of pair? Pair means how many things, how many articles. Pair. Do you know? Yes, very good. This one. Two. Pair of shoes. Pair of shoes. Shoes. How many are it? Two. Pair means two articles. Okay. Pair of handbags means two handbags. Two handbags cost is rupees 480. Then how much will it cost if she bought five such bags? Here asking cost of five bags. Okay, cost of five handbags. First here two handbags cost given. We have to find out first here five bags cost. What we do, children? First cost of one handbag. Cost of one handbag. First step. What given in question? First we have to write first of all. Cost of pair of bags. Cost of pair of bags rupees 480. Next, cost of five bags. Yeah, cost of a pair of bags given. We have to find out five bags. Cost of five bags. How can we do first? How can we solve? First, one bag cost. We have to find out first one bag cost. Cost of one bag. First of all, pay me. Pay means two articles. Cost of one bag. Equal 480 divided by 2. 480 divided by 2. Thank you. problem continuation. 480 divided by 2. Two twos are four. Two fours are eight. Two zeros are zero. Okay. What is the cost of one bag? 240. Very good. Cost of one handbag. Rupees 240. Then we have to find out cost of five bags. The cost of five bags. Listen, children. Once again, I will explain this problem. Listen, children. All of you. Listen here. First, Veena bought a pair of handbags. First, what we know? Pair means what? What is the meaning of pair? Pair means two articles. Means first here word given in question. Two handbags cost given. What is the cost of two handbags? Rupees 480. 480 rupees. So first we have to find out one bag cost. Okay, cost of one bag. Next, we have to find out five such bags. Okay, cost of five bags. First, what we have to write? First of all, cost of a pair of bags. How much cost given? Right, children, baby. 480. Next, cost of five bags. We have to find out cost of five bags. What we do first? Pair means we know already. What is the meaning of pair? Pair means two articles. First, we have to find out cost of one bag. How can we find out? With division. 480 divided by 2. What is 2? Pair of handbags. Pair means two articles. That's why we have to do division by divided by 2. Cost of one bag. What is the cost of one handbag? 240. How can we find out? With division. 480 divided by 2. 2 twos are 4, 2 fours are 8, 2 zeros are 0. Next, cost of 5 handbags. What we do? With multiplication. 240 into 5. 240 into 5. What is the product? 1200. Cost of 5 handbags? Rupees 1200. 1200 rupees. 5 handbags cost is 1200 rupees. First, we have to division after multiplication. In unitary method, we follow the first division afterwards multiplication. Did you understand, children, how to solve unitary method problems? Okay, first we have to do first division. One of the cost. We have to find out one of the cost. Afterwards, we have to how many things given? We have to find out the that many things cost. Okay, very good. Rajput Nirma, understand. Okay, next. In this problem, if you have any doubt, raise your hand, children. Anybody? Understand. Okay, no doubt. Okay, no doubt. In your textbook, see, children, once. Okay, I will explain second problem also now. Next, remaining exercise 5.1 and revision exercise. Revision exercise also same unitary method method problems only. You follow same as it is this method only. You have to solve your own. Then if you have any doubt, you call me and you send me message. Okay, what is your problem? Then in next class, in tomorrow class, I will explain same that problem only. Okay, na? Okay. Now I will explain second problem. What is second problem? Write down from textbook too. What is second one? Harish bought a dozen bunions. Rupees 381. What would be the cost of 8 such bunions? See children, here Harish bought a dozen bunions for rupees 381. Yes, dozen means 12 articles. Dozen bunions means 12 bunions. What would be the cost of 8 such bunions? We have to find out cost of 8 bunions. Okay, first we have to find out 1 bunion cost. How can we find out 381 divided by 12? How to write steps? First, cost of dozen bunions. Rupees 381. Okay. Dozen means 12 articles. Next, first we have to find out cost of 1 bunion. Do division. First, 38. Nearest and smallest number from 12 table. 12 threes are 36. 21. 12 ones are 12. 21 minus 12. Yes. 9.0. 12 sevens are 84. 6. 19 minus 84. 6. 60. 12 fives are 60. What is the cost of 1 bunion? 31 rupees 75 paise. 31 rupees 75 paise each bunion cost. Then we have to find out 8 bunions cost. 8 fives are 40, 8 sevens are 56, 56 plus 4, 60, 8 ones are 8, 8 plus 6, 14, next 8 threes are 24, 24 plus 1, 25. What is the answer? 254 rupees. 8 bunions cost is 254 rupees. Okay, did you understand, children? How to do unitary method problems? First we have to do division. After we have to do multiplication. First we have to find out each one cost or one of the cost. Next, in problem what given, how many things cost we have to find out. Then we have to find out that many things cost. Okay. If you have any doubt, raise your hand. Okay, remaining problems try to your own, children. Page number 64, exercise 5.1 and revision exercise problems. Try to do. Okay. Then, if you have any doubt, in tomorrow class also I will explain same problems. Okay. Thank you, children. Thank you.